Hello. In this video, we're going to be looking at how to add additional light to the scene using the window geometry here. For this example, I downloaded a 3D model from the internet, which gives us a nice interior scene to work with. Let's get started by going inside, double-click, and we're going to select the faces of the windows. Hit the 4 key to select faces and select them both. Now go to Modify, Extract, and we're going to make those windows into its own object. And you can see that we have a new object node from that window geometry here. Let's go back up to object level, and we're just going to rename that. And let's put it together with the other object nodes. Turn off visibility on it. And hey, we can still see the windows. That'll be because we didn't delete the original window faces. The extract node only duplicated the selected geometry. So let's grab them and delete them. Go back up object level, and next we'll need a camera. Let's find an OK position, just lock it to the camera view first. We can turn off the lock function now. And now we're back to the default camera view. One more thing we'll need, a Mantra PBR node. Go to Render, Create Render Node, and select Mantra PBR. And there's a render node. Let's go to the Render View tab. Change the render camera to the one we put down earlier. And I'm going to turn off preview and auto update. Keep this on if you want to see your render update anytime you make a parameter change. I'm turning it off just for the purpose of optimizing video recording. Before we hit render, we're just going to change the render image size. You can choose any of these image rescaling amounts and specify the resolution. There's a list of standard display resolutions, or you can type your own. Click on Render. By the way, I've time-lapsed the render in order to keep the video shorter. So, there is our scene with two area lights. Let's put down a portal light and see what we get. Just going to do a snapshot of this render. Let's go back to the Scene View tab. And let's make a new tab here. Click and drag to move it to the front. And we're going to pin it so that we can keep it on the Mantra render node. For this tab, we're going to point it to the object level nodes. Click on the pin. And now we can quickly switch back and forth between the two without having to reselect object or out each time. So let's click on the window geo node and then click on portal light. There's our portal light. Let's just organize it. Change the color. Give it a name, and back to render view. Let's focus in on the area where the portal light is. Hold down Shift and left mouse button click and drag to select a region to render. So, you can see that there is light on the window area, but it's kind of dim. Let's add an environment map and boost the light intensity. But first, a snapshot. Just pull this out a bit. Make sure only portal light is selected. Let's do a snapshot to compare. And you can middle mouse button scroll to zoom in. Yep, that's pretty noisy. Let's clean it up a bit. In the Mantra render node, in the rendering tab, we're going to raise the max ray samples count. This will increase the number of rays bouncing in our scene, which will help to give more light information as well as reduce noise. We're also going to lower the noise level to 0.001. And let's see what we get. There's not much difference, so we're going to enable indirect sample limits. This will give us independent control over the max ray samples for indirect light, which is where you'll find the bulk of your noise. We're also going to match the noise level, keeping the direct and indirect values the same. In addition, we're going to change the reflect and refract limit to 1, since we don't have any shiny or glassy materials here. Side note, the diffuse limit is set to 1 by default if you create the Mantra node via the drop-down menu like we did earlier. If you go the tab key route, then diffuse limit is set to 0 by default, so just keep that in mind. Let's go to increase the max indirect ray sampling. Usually, I'd increase these numbers by values of 16, 32, and so on. Start low and work your way up. We're going to increase the pixel samples to 4, which will increase the overall sampling done per pixel. We were at 3x3, which means 9 samples per 1 pixel in your render. 4x4 means we'll be doing 16 samples on 1 pixel. Also, increasing the sampling quality within your light can help to reduce noise as well. And it's generally less expensive for renders. It's looking cleaner now. Take a snapshot. And let's scrub through them to see the progression. Okay, let's hit the H key to go back to 1-to-1 scale. And now we're going to open the render scheduler to keep track of our render time. Just going to uncheck clear completed jobs. And then hold down shift and left mouse button click outside of the render image to clear our render region selection. So, we were at about 8 minutes 34 seconds render time. Let's take a snapshot and we're going to compare this against the render time and results of using a regular environment light. Portal lights are basically environment lights with a portal geometry parameter option. Here we have our window geometry we extracted earlier. You can assign other geometry in your scene as portal light by clicking here. If we disable this parameter, this will then turn it back to a regular environment light. See? Environment light. Let's hit render. So we only took a little bit longer than the portal light render. But you'll notice that we have way more noise and also light in places where there shouldn't be. So, let's turn back on portal geometry, change our resolution to 720p, and increase the max indirect ray sampling to 128. Just want to see a clean final render before we wrap this up. And then click on render to end play. So here's our final render demonstrating the use of portal lights inside Houdini. Thanks for watching.